Overseas tonight, more suspects charged in connections with the Brussels terror attacks. According to our parent website, Newsmax.com, two men now charged with participating in terrorist activities and an additional three people detained following the search of a house in Brussels. To talk more about this, we're pleased to be joined by former CIA analyst Fred Fleitz, who's currently Senior Vice President for Policy and Programs at the Center for Security Policy. Fred, as we take a look at what's happening in Belgium, do we have any idea what role these new suspects may have played in the Brussels bombings?
I haven't heard what role they have played, but I think this is simply the latest indication that there's a very large network, a very large ISIS Islamic network in Europe operating out of Belgium and other countries. And I think it's much larger than anyone had anticipated. What's significant about these arrests is that these individuals were from a different neighborhood of Brussels, not the Molenbeek neighborhood that the other suspects were arrested. It is simply another area that's operating as an Islamist safe haven in the heart of Europe.
And so you talk about this network being larger than a lot of people suspected. Is there any way, a ballpark figure on just how many might be involved, especially when we've seen neighborhood, I don't want to say conspiracy, but accommodation in certain neighborhoods there in Brussels?
Well, we've just heard hundreds thrown around. And the biggest concern here is that many of these individuals have been traveling back and forth to Syria to fight in Syria and come back to basically commit criminal actions and terrorist activities for ISIS in Europe.
And so it seems like a simple matter of just keeping an eye on who shows up on travel manifests back to the Middle East and then return back to Belgium. But what do I know? I'm not law enforcement. And with the 2 minutes remaining, I just have to ask you, have the Belgians done anything to counteract the reputation of being weak on this, being soft on this, not doing what they should have been doing?
Well, they're cracking down after the fact, but we now know there's been a lot of press coverage about how bad the Belgian security services is. The country is split along linguistic line, so are their police services and intelligence services, and this has made it harder for them to crack down on these Islamist terrorists, you know, living in their midst. They're doing some good things now, but whether that will continue, I don't know.
There is one other controversy where I'd like to get your perspective. Over the weekend, CIA Director John Brennan told NBC News he would not permit CIA officers to utilize waterboarding, even if he were ordered to by the president. Your reaction to what Director Brennan had to say?
I thought this was an outrageous statement. You know, Brennan is trying to say if ordered by the next president, he won't commit waterboarding. Let me tell you, if there's a Republican president, he will be shown the door on the first day of office of the next president. Brennan has been one of the most political CIA directors in the agency's history. He's been involved in dismissing the threat from radical Islam, trying to read Miranda rights to terrorists. And I see this as an effort by Brennan to intervene in the presidential campaign, frankly, to suck up to Hillary Clinton, hoping that she will keep him on. I thought it was an outrageous thing to say.
And you say he is the most political of CIA directors? We've got about 30 seconds.
In my opinion, he is definitely the most political CIA director. Remember the role he played in the politicized Benghazi talking points that Susan Rice used on the air on five television networks? I mean, this man has crossed the line of the non-political role CIA directors are supposed to play.
Fred Fleitz from Washington. Fred, we appreciate your perspective. And as you watch and listen to what Fred had to say, I'm interested in your perspective as well. Agree or disagree? Why don't you send your comments to me? And you can send them to newsmaxtv.com/comments. Or if you're all wrapped up in the Twittersphere, you can use Twitter, where our handle is at Newsmax Prime. When we come back, we'll talk more politics with Liz Peek and Mark Alderman. Stay with us.